Yeah, perfect day. I totally agree. So if I would have been allowed to paint the last day of the last home game in the season, I would paint it exactly like this. So yeah, at first difficult game, close game. We were back 9-1, so with the first strike on the goal, but yeah, we turned the game, came back, and I think with a really really good second half and a well deserved win. Although it was a hard struggle up to the end, and then to have Wesula in here in his last game, yeah, unbelievable atmosphere for his final game, and he is there pretty crucial for this win. So he proved again that he's still able to win championship games for us. He's there with his first goal of the season in his last game. Yeah, in addition to that, an assist, and I think especially in the second half, a really really good performance. And then to have this atmosphere all together, so it was brilliant, and for me also pretty important to finish the season in style and really on a high, also for the whole atmosphere, for the confidence, also for the next season, because the final home game, this mood you always take, everyone takes it into the summer break, and yeah, for that was pretty a pretty good day for us.
And obviously, as you say, Wes quite rightly is the headline. Just that moment when he came off and the players hugged him, and then you hugged him as well. Was there a few tears from Wes? We couldn't quite see from the press box.
Well, a lot of tears, and I got the feeling. So normally he's always in a good mood and with a smile on his face. But yeah, when we met in this morning, his face was anyhow pretty white, and you could see he's a bit nervous, and that's also a sign of his character. He's nearly 36 years old and had so many games, but he's nervous before each and every game, and wants to be there with a good performance, and he plays football with all his heart, and football is his passion, and for that then he knows that there is this final game, and yeah, when there will be the final substitution in its last moment as a player for Norwich City, yeah, he feels this with all his heart, and yeah, it was pretty emotional over the day, and still right now in the dressing room, but in general, so I think unbelievable moments, and I'm pretty sure that Wes will never forget this day.
It shows the affection he's held in by the fans, the players, the coaching staff, that you could see the desire was there to give him the fitting send off he deserved.
Yes, I got the feeling during the whole week that all the players, the whole staff is greedy to give him this present, to have a really brilliant final home game. And Wes made it clear and said, listen, let's concentrate during the whole week. I want to win this last game. And then, yeah, everyone is focused so much on winning this game. And then it's quite difficult if you concede such a goal and you're back 1-0. So it's really difficult for the head. But we showed a lot of character today and a lot of togetherness. And we're able to turn the game for Wes. And Wes in a pretty crucial role as well. Yeah, brilliant.
Do you think there was a little bit of another power? I mean, you saw the goal. It's like a deflection off the defender. Hit one post, hit the other post and gone in. Something else at work today.
Could be. I think it's also a sign of his character, because Wes is not only a brilliant footballer who can sometimes do something magic on the pitch, but he's also a hard worker. And in this scene, was Mario Francis was there with a really good win of the ball, and yeah, Wes forced it with a really good dribbling, and you could feel that he's greedy to create something because he realized, okay, we have some problems because we conceded this goal, and yeah, then he was there and tried to be there with a concentrated strike. But if you work hard and if you want to force your luck, then you have this moment of a bit luck that the shoot is so deflected that the ball hits the post, and yeah, it felt really like it took 2 minutes if the ball decides to go over the line or perhaps out, and yeah, but when you work so hard and you have such a great career, it's well deserved that the ball goes over the line, and I got the feeling totally the right moment today.
I mean, you paid a nice tribute to him all through the week, and we asked you again on Friday, but now that's it, it's his final game. How big a hole is Wes Hoolan leave in terms of the squad and the club as well?
A big hole in so many topics, because first of all, he's still a brilliant footballer, and he's proved today again that he's still able to win championship games, and he had a big effect in many many games, especially when he came in as a substitute, and then the crowd is there and he can create something crazy and something special. It's not easy to replace him from the sports side, but we have to do this. But yeah, also because he's there was an unbelievable personality also in the dressing room, so an experienced player, but not in the way that he wants to be there like a teacher for the players. It's more like he's really one of my lads, and he gives his experience without any pressure to the young lads in a really nice and gentle way. And he's really a role model for so many players. It's not easy to fulfill what he has done for this club. Yeah, but anyway, there is this moment when a player decides, and like I mentioned before, so I got the feeling he find a final game in style, and really he finished his Norwich City career on a high, and that's what I think all really good players are looking for. And not easy for us to replace him, 100% not. But for him, I think a perfect finish of his Norwich City period, and brilliant day for him.
Daniel, do you have any idea where you might end up playing next? Do you know anything about that? Or is it obviously up to West, but have you got any feeling about where he might end up next season?
No, so I would have some ideas, but I'm not sure what he's doing. So we didn't speak about this topic so far. I think for him it was important to finish really his last game, because it was so emotional for him. I don't think that there is already a decision or whatever. I think he wants to end his period with Norwich City, because I got the feeling he's a Norwich City player with 100% and with all his heart. And I got the feeling before this period is not finished, he's not able to decide what is coming next. I think he has some thoughts, but I'm not sure what
he will play next season. Do you think he will play somewhere next season? Retire.
If you ask me to be, yeah. I would say hopefully, because he's still in such a good shape, and I tell all my players in the nicest period of the time as a footballer is always when you play football. As a coach, it's sometimes nice as well, but the nicest time is always as a footballer. And I give my players always the message: so play as long as you can. And as long as you are on a really good level, it's up to West to decide if he still feels he can go further on this level, and what he decides to do.